welcome to Wishtrenders. We got you! Yay! Hi, Iris.
Hi.
How are thy?
I am Iris as well. How are you?
Eunice is doing pretty good. So, what's today's theme today?
Today's theme: step solutions for summer skincare.
Perfect. It is so hot in Korea these days. It's getting really hot and humid. Yes, and one of the most difficult things is, of course, skincare. It's becoming very challenging due to the weather. And
I'm trying to turn it off. Okay, yes, here's the fan.
Perfect. So we've received a lot of skin concerns from you guys through the survey in our community tab, and we will recommend custom solutions for you guys. And the first one was morning skincare. Second one was makeup. Third one was night skincare, and fourth one was cleansing. And by 42%, morning skincare won the first place.
Ooh.
That's pretty high, right?
Okay, 42%. That's very high. That's almost like half.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So summer skincare, as we all know, is not easy. And especially after we shower, whether that's in the morning or before you sleep.
Right.
For me, it feels like I start sweating like right after I shower. Yes. So it's like, did I just take a shower or no?
I
want to hop in the shower again.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like lots of you guys are going to relate to what we're going to be telling you guys today.
Yeah, definitely. And as I mentioned before in the last live too, but I don't have an AC in my room for 34 years of my life.
Yes.
So after my shower too, I'm like, oh my gosh, everything seems like it's like melting.
Yeah.
And you don't want to put any products on. It's really difficult because the outside temperature is so hot.
Yeah.
But when you go into like, you know, offices and things like that, schools, it's all cold.
Yeah, it's cold.
Yeah.
There is no in between.
Exactly. So the condition just gets worse and worse. So I think that's why we're more prone to breakouts and problematic skin. Yeah, definitely.
From Psalm, I'm always worried about sweating and what it might do to my skin alongside with the heat. I'm living in a hot country, so I need to frequently reapply sunscreen. Can you share how to reapply sunscreen?
Great question. So I think that kind of, we can categorize it into two questions. The first one is, how does heat affect our skin? And the second question is, how do you reapply sunscreen, right?
So for the first question, your skin's temperature can reach up to 40 degrees Celsius when it's exposed to UV rays for even just 15 minutes. So when you're at work or when you're on your way to work, maybe you're at the station, you're walking to work, or just grabbing lunch, it can still affect your skin and make it heat up. So you really need to pay attention.
Exactly. So if your temperature rises, your capillary vessels extend, and that's why your skin becomes dry, your pores enlarge, and then you have lack of elasticity, and all of these bad just cycle goes over and over and over again. And as your temperature rises just even 1 degree Celsius, 10% of sebum production increases. That's a lot. Imagine just 1 degree. So on the opposite side, if you lower your skin's temperature just by 1 degree, that means it can just really help to make your condition into a place where your skin can be very healthy. So keep that in mind, guys.
Mm-hmm. And it's best to try to keep your skin at 31 degrees Celsius.
Right.
And we know it's not easy, like, oh, my skin feels like it's 40 degrees.
I have a machine.
It's hard, we know, but it's dangerous to put ice directly on your skin just because, oh, my face is hot. Like, I feel like I'm at 40 degrees.
Right.
Even if your face is like burning or just feels like it's really heated, don't ever put ice directly on your skin because, you know, rapid temperature change is really, really bad for your skin. So it's important to try to lower the temperature slowly.
If it has cooling effects, and it's gonna really, really help to soothe your skin at the same time. So I think personally for me, I really love using the Claire's Blue Cream. Do we have it here? Midnight Blue Calming Cream. And this is an amazing product for the summertime. Definitely.
It's really calming. Mm-hmm. It's like really calming. Seriously, it's not really, really blue as it looks.
Yeah.
That doesn't make sense, but it's seriously not like a chemically blue color.
It has no artificial coloring.
Yeah, to be honest, I was kind of scared when I
first saw it. In the beginning,
it's blue. What am I going to do with this blue cream? But it's really good, guys.
It's from that beautiful ingredient called guazuline. It's all natural baby.
Fancy.
Here. Okay, so I'm just gonna soak that in. Okay. And personally for me, in the morning time, this may feel a little bit heavy for you guys. So at nighttime is so nice after you come back home and you just wanna cool it down. And I'll go back and soothe it down.
And I also feel like just putting it on places where you feel extra dry helps. Like not all over, just places you want to pay attention to.
Right, right, right.
And some people think, and we've said this last time during our live, but we said to wash your face when you feel like you're heating up. But sometimes we can't wash your face, like maybe you're at the office or you have schedules outside, then you know, you really, or you have makeup on, you can't wash your face. So to give you a simple way to solve that problem is to literally just spritz a mist.
That's it.
Yeah, it's as easy as that, and especially if it's a soothing mist, it's going to help with the redness as well, because sometimes I blush up so much from the heat that you can see like the redness through my foundation.
Right, right, right.
So I feel like using a soothing mist is going to help with both the heat and the blushing redness.
Perfect. And now the second tip is, especially when you have makeup on, it's really, really not easy. However, it's very, very simple. We ask you to get the toner. Yes, right here the for toner. You guys. Was it weird?
Weird. It's fine. I like it.
Okay, so what you're gonna do is get a tissue. And should we just show you guys right off the bat? Just
we
get
shall.
One tissue. Because sometimes, you know, you don't even have like wet towels. You know,
no.
You don't have
cleansing,
like, cleansing
tissues,
tissue. You
no.
know? So just get any tissue and then just spray.
Ooh.
Some mist, and make sure that you get all the gunk off of your skin first.
So like blotting gently.
This can't really take away 200% of all the gunk away. However, it can take a large portion of it like off your face. So this is a really easy tip for you guys. And then what you're gonna do is you can just reapply sunscreen. That's it. Reapply your sunscreen with a sponge, makeup sponge. And afterwards, if you feel like your skin looks too oily still, what you can do is get another tissue.
Ooh.
And just wipe it like this, just to wrap it up, and then just go on top. And you can just kind of use it to make sure you get rid of the oiliness or the greasiness on top.
This is a really good tip.
And so Carr says, what products do you most recommend for the skin in the morning, especially for the combination skin types? I sometimes feel that I'm using more than needed in the morning. I feel you guys on that one. Should I just cleanse and moisturize? Or what would you recommend?
So in the summer, we all know that even if we don't like move a lot, we still get really sweaty and we still heat up
definitely.
A lot, just because, you know, I feel like just sitting there still makes us like heat up because it's so, so hot. And in Korea, I heard it's like it went up to 40 degrees last week.
It's just getting really hot.
It's important to keep your skin fresh.
Right.
So I feel like moderately subtracting or adding your skincare steps can actually help you keep your skin and body feel fresh. But like if you're applying the same amount of high nutrient products or oils, just like in the winter, like in the summer, it's not going to work.
It's because, too much.
Yeah, it's going to feel heavy and it's going to cause skin problems because in the winter, you want to really deeply hydrate. So you're using like this much of product. But in the summer, you actually just want to apply less because less is more in the summer. If you're reducing your skincare steps to like 50% or 70%.
That's a lot.
Yeah, that's still going to cause your skin to pull because of dryness. So we recommend you moderately change your skincare steps in the summer and like add or subtract depending on what your skin feels like, because everyone's different and we've all got different skincare steps and you know, skin types. So we recommend you just ask your skin, look how it works, and just try different steps.
Yeah, so many of us has concerns, especially during the summertime, where our outside layer looks really oily and greasy and black, but inside it feels like it's
dry,
it's dehydrated.
Especially with combination skin.
Exactly. So oily skin types that lack moisture experience some type of that uncomfortable feeling on your skin. So what you should do is use products that are less oily with high hydrating effects, exactly what you need to keep a really good balance of that moisture and oil balance for your skin. So this mist, this is the Claire's Fundamental Ample Mist, and it sprays on really nicely too. Can you see it through the camera? I'm gonna put it on my face too. And all you have to do is put your face just a few times. It's very, very hydrating. And with this one, the thing is that the main base is 82% green tea, unlike other mists out there, that the main base is thermal water. So that's why sometimes when you start misting, you're like, I'm misting like throughout the whole day, but I feel like my skin's still really dry, right? So that is because usually check the ingredient list. Usually those kind of mists that feel like it's already drying and stuff like that, the main base is thermal water. It's not like green tea or grape water. So we do want to recommend a mist list. And this is a really, really good one for the summertime because it has ingredients to lock in the moisture. So yeah, just keep that in mind. And remember that number one, use cleansers. Don't use cleansers in the morning or use it in only certain parts of your face that's oily. And then mist. And then of course, we were talking about it throughout the whole time, but sunscreen, right?
Yeah, sunscreen. Okay,
perfect.
But for those of you guys who feel like you're not a misty kind of person, or if your mist kind of feels sticky in the morning, or for some reason you just don't want to apply your mist, then also using a soothing serum can work.
It's very like
watery, and it doesn't feel oily at all.
It looks, it's just so cooling. Yeah. You wanna pop it in the fridge and then put it on.
It feels jelly like. And so anyway, back to the ingredient thing, you wanna make sure there are no irritating products or irritating ingredients in them because you want to stay with safe, healthy skincare. And you don't want to use harmful ingredients on your skin, right?
Like, exactly.
Or anywhere. Dan, I love to know the big tips and tricks on how to get all of the dirt and grime out of my pores after a long day.
Right.
I also have a part-time job in a fast food place, so the fryer oil really clogs my pores and causes me acne.
Alright guys, that's a really good question. Thank you for sharing your story with us. Your skin is more prone to cause skin problems if the sweating and the dust or even the oil gets mixed up and starts clogging your pores. So the best thing you can do is thoroughly cleanse your skin, right? It's very important. We feel like the number one tip, if we can say, for the summertime is really thorough cleansing.
Stick to basics.
Exactly, because it is a must to apply sunscreens to. Some people think like makeup is more heavy than sunscreens, but sunscreens is really difficult to take it off too. So you always have to keep that in mind. But we do not recommend that you cleanse too often or too harshly. Sometimes we think if we do it often or if we do it like harshly that it will really get rid of everything. But you have to do it in a gentle and mild way. However, you have to use a good product that can thoroughly cleanse your skin, guys. Right? This product here.
It's pink. Matches our theme.
It does. Okay, I'm going to switch the cameras later on. But this is the by Wishtrend Acid Duo 2% Mild Gel Cleanser. I personally really like this product. Mm-hmm. I used it this morning too. And it's really important that this is a low pH cleanser.
Ooh, so low
it,
pH.
Yes, it doesn't have to be this cleanser, guys, but use a low pH cleanser because that's gonna help your skin to be in a very, very healthy condition. Squeaky clean feeling, we're kind of used to that because we think it's gonna be really good for our skin, but those are alkaline ones that are not really great. It contains artificial surfactants sometimes. So if your cleanser right now gives you that boop, 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 you know, but you guys make sure that it does, it's a cleanser that doesn't strip away the necessary moisture and oil on your skin, okay? Alright guys, so I'm gonna be talking about this now. Shall we switch over and I'll show you the beautifulness right here? As I mentioned before, I used this morning too. This is a by Wishtrend Acid Duo 2% Mild Gel Cleanser. The best part about this is, can you hold this for 1 second? I always carry around this when I travel. The first reason, this is so comfortable. Do you know? It locks. Yeah, it locks completely so it never leaks when I travel. Love using this. It exfoliates your skin while it cleanses your skin thoroughly. So this is really, really a good cleanser.
And so just like cleansing, it's important to prevent your skin problems in the summer by removing your sebum at a proper time. So it's not like just any time you can just go cleanse your face, right?
Whenever you want to.
Yeah, because we've got life, we've got school, we've got work. So when you are caring for your pores, we recommend you do it once to twice a week because doing it too many times is just going to largen up your pores. And if you get loose pores, whiteheads, and blackheads are going to pile up.
And it's just a vicious cycle,
it's
man.
It's just terrifying. Yeah. Just by like trying to explain it to you guys. Like, imagine your blackheads and whiteheads piled up on each other. Okay, so this is a charcoal soap that contains charcoal ingredients. And let's just, I'm just showing you the box, which is going to help. Ooh, look how black it is.
Yeah, I love the new packaging because they used to just have like paper.
Does it smell like charcoal?
Yeah, it does. It has a very...
Ooh, right? Like a soapy, clean charcoal
scent
smell.
To it too, yeah.
So how to do it? How to do it, just foam up your soap either with your hands or, you know, nowadays they have those like foamers where you put the soap in and it makes like a lot of bubbles for you.
It makes life easier.
Yeah. So then just foam up your soap,
right.
Put it on your face, and if you want to gently remove your blackheads, we recommend you use a tool.
Look how cute this is. This is so cute.
Yes.
This is really affordable too. It's not expensive.
You can see there's like these, it's like texture kind of, and it's like rubber-like. It isn't focusing, is it? Yes. Okay, there we go. Can you guys see the texture? And then you just...
I think from the side, maybe. Yeah, right there. I could see it.
And then you're going to just use this to... When you have the bubbles, of course.
Right. So you want
to layer your face with the foam and then just gently rub using a tool, whether it's like something like this or, you know, they use the brush,
the pore brush. Yeah.
But you have to be careful. You're being really gentle because you don't want to enlarge your pores.
No, you don't want to
stimulate it. More than how they are right now. Yeah. So you want to be gentle and don't use it frequently. Like we said, once or twice a week is going to be fair, because if you just go too harsh on your skin or you do it too frequently, it's actually going to strip down your skin and it's going to make your pores larger and it's going to lead to sensitive skin. Hey you, star.
Okay.
Night routines, because I'm removing a whole day's worth of sweat, grime, and makeup. I tend to work out in the evening, so it's even more important. And especially in the summer heat, I need to cool down and soothe my skin or it gets really irritated. Oh my gosh, working out in the evening.
Yeah, I know.
Good job. Okay, so guys,
a regular, like the right amount, just the right amount of workout is really important in the summertime because we become so lazy.
Yeah.
And I become really lazy. Right? It's so hot. We do not want to go outdoors. It's not really easy for us to, let's go work out. You know, it becomes more difficult.
No.
Exactly. So in the summer, we're more prone to be dehydrated as our sweat, it doesn't like evaporate well due to the hot temperature. So we also feel really tired easily.
Yeah? Yes.
That's why after lunch, you're all like... falling asleep and, you know, things like that. You guys all experience this, right?
Your body feels heavier.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think you can also, in Korea, we say 더위 먹었다.
Yeah.
But it's like heat strokes.
Yeah,
You really suffer from heat strokes, which exist. People say does that exist?
No, I feel like scientifically it does exist.
Right.
But like other places other than Korea, they just don't have a right word to name it.
Yeah.
But yeah.
So in Korean, if you translate it, you say like 더위 먹었다
means you ate heat. Yeah.
But we really understand what it
means. It feels like your body is heat.
We really need to focus on the proper amount of exercising. Exercises that are good time. Oh, excuse me. Exercises, doing it the right amount is just perfect. If you do it too much, it will be too much for you. Your body, your skin will not be able to handle it. If you do the right amount, it will be perfect for you. So some exercises that we do want to recommend to cool down the heat is swimming.
Oh,
because you could
smart.
Fight off the heat right off the bat,
and also
right?
exercise at the same time.
Yeah, so I think I personally love going to, you know, going swimming, going to the beach. In Korea, there's not that many swimming pools compared to America or other, you know, countries. So that's like the sad part, but it's a perfect choice that we do want to recommend if you want to cool off and kill off the heat at the same time. Mm-hmm. And we do recommend that you work out at nighttime. Because around 10 o'clock or 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock is the most hot time, right? 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. is like the time that the sun is the strongest. So we do recommend early in the morning or after that
time. When the
time.
Sun is not down. Rising up or when it's down.
Exactly.
And to add another tip, rather than exercising for a like long time, just we recommend you stick to within an hour because...
That's good.
Yeah,
for me.
You know,
that's good enough for me.
It's just like other things, like when you're eating or when you're practicing something or when you're studying, you want to concentrate in a short amount of time rather than just like making the time itself longer without like high concentration.
Right.
And you need to have enough breaks in between. Mm. And also, just like what Eunice just did, drink your water, guys.
Drink coffee.
No, it's water, guys.
Drink water.
Yeah, we're gonna pretend it's water. And even if you don't feel thirsty, you can still get dehydrated because that doesn't come with a warning, guys.
Exactly.
Dehydration.
Exactly.
So make sure you're just like watering yourself.
Watering yourself.
Though you don't feel thirsty.
Yes.
And also put on sportswear or loose outfits that are good for heat emission when you're going outdoors. Mm. Like, you don't want to wear something that's going to make you hot.
Exactly.
Or, you know, like heat tech, you know, like in Korea. And, you know, they have the heat tech thing where it makes you feel warm.
Yeah.
But just try to stick with, like, sports gear. Because sports gear is there
and there's
for a
like
reason.
Clothing that actually lower your body temperature.
Yeah,
too,
yeah.
Right?
I saw some commercials
right,
like that.
Right, right. So you guys can check
Not
out those
promoting,
things
but yeah. Tips, guys.
Yeah. Washing with lukewarm water helps to lower your skin's temperature to, you know, some degree. It really does help, you know. But to immediately calm your skin, it's really good to apply sheet masks.
Yes.
I know it's really
instant effects.
It's so easy. Just pop it in the fridge for about 5 to 10 minutes. It gets really, really shuone, like refreshing. It gets cold. And if you can feel that coolness, you will be addicted to it. You'll want to do it again and then again and again. And it's really, really easy. But sometimes when your skin is too hot to a point where you're like, even the sheet mask, it turned warm right off the bat because of my skin, because it's so hot. What you can do is, these coolers are really cheap. It doesn't even have to be this big old ones. It could be very small ones. You can just pop it in the fridge. It's no problem. All you have to do is put on the sheet mask and then just roll it. That's all you have to do.
Ooh.
This is nice. I think I should get a bigger one because I have the smaller one, but it takes me like a long time for it to cool down. But
I think it's going to help with the puffiness in the morning when your face gets all like puffy.
Yeah.
You can use it too. And you can also use like these to, you know, when after you work out, your calves get really hardened.
Oh, it'll be so
moisture left on your body while using the roller, and try using a lotion or gel type product if you want to have a more smooth experience.
Yeah, and basically Iris said wash it, and that's
wash it, guys.
Wash it after
wash
you
it.
Use it, wash it, don't pop it in the freezer, you know, freeze it again.
Wash
so
it, guys.
Perfect. And then our producer told us like that this, they use it at the Korean dermatology. So yeah, that's a good tip. Maybe I can buy one from there.
Maybe do it like on your jawline if you want to become more like V-line, guys.
V-line.